First interview since being sentenced to 3 years in federal prison. The president's former personal attorney claims he was following Trump's instructions about the payoffs.
He directed me to make the payments. He directed me to become involved in these matters. You have to remember at what point in time that this matter came about, 2 weeks or so before the election, post the Billy Bush comments. So yes, he was very concerned about how this would affect the election.
To help his campaign.
To help him and the campaign.
But President Trump is saying Cohen's lying about what actually happened.
I never directed him to do anything incorrect or wrong. And he understands that. Look, he did some bad things unrelated to me, maybe related to his other clients. I wasn't his only client. Wow. Michael Cohen pled guilty to something that's not even a crime. Wait a minute. These are campaign. Nobody, except for me, would be looked at like this. Nobody. What about Congress, where they have a slush fund and millions of dollars is paid out each year?
Also breaking today, the special counsel turning over documents to a judge in the Michael Flynn case. The response coming after Flynn's attorneys argued that the FBI encouraged the former national security advisor to do an interview with agents without agents present. Lawyers. Robert Mueller's team claims Flynn should have known it was a crime to lie to the FBI, but the documents say they never warned him beforehand. All right, Emily, let's go back to the first part. The president says, what about Congress? They have this big slush fund that they use with taxpayer money to settle sexual misconduct cases. That's never reported anywhere. Aren't there just felonies galore in Congress?
Wait a minute.
Juan, I was talking
to Emily.
Is your name Emily?
But let me ask, have we just moved away from Cohen and all that happened today?
Well, I'm not hijacking.
It's only 5:02.
The segment.
Juan.
I'm trying to lay it out specifically.
Oh my gosh, this is
Juan. What's gotten into you?
I just think it's whataboutism run rampant. Go right ahead.
I take offense to that.
Okay.
Go ahead, Emily.
Thanks, Emily. So here's how I think about that. There is a bill right now in Congress being pushed through bilaterally that will take out from the salary expenditures that taxpayers pay in terms of paying that harassment thing. So that will be changed. I do think that it's a little bit of a shell game. I want to point out, if I can, though, that everyone is talking about the specific intent associated with it. And I just want to make sure that viewers understand that, yes, that's what separates a civil from a criminal campaign finance violation charge. But most importantly to me is that Flynn situation. I think it's a hideous abuse of power to treat any of those kinds of conversations casually, and that we can never overestimate the amount of weight that the government brings with it every time they just sit down and ask, hey, how are you? And so for Comey then to blame it on a disorganized administration, and so I thought I'd send a couple guys over, I think is a horrible abuse of power, 100%. And regardless what happens with the judge reviewing the Flynn documents, and regardless of what he should have known, there is no way that when someone sits down and says, hey, I have a couple questions for you, but oh, if you want, I can grab a warrant and go through the DOJ, but, or we can just sit, if you think that you will not acquiesce to that, it's not the same thing.
Well, Juan does not want to talk about the Flynn case. Juan wants to talk about Michael Cohen.
Wait. To her point.
Oh, go ahead.
Yeah. To her point. I actually really hated how Comey told the story. He acted like a celebrity on the Tonight Show.
Do we have that tape?
I don't know.
Do you want to play some Comey tape about how he sent the agents in? Let's roll it and then react.
Something I probably wouldn't have done or maybe gotten away with in a more organized investigation, a more organized administration, in the George W. Bush administration, for example, or the Obama administration. So if the FBI wanted to send agents into the White House itself to interview a senior official, you would work through the White House counsel, and there'd be discussions and approvals and who would be there. And I thought, it's early enough, let's just send a couple guys over.
And so they laugh, It just felt like He was playing with somebody's life, but it was funny and clever. Hey, you know, they're kind of disorganized. We could send some people over there. That's kind of scummy.
He said, you know, we got away with it.
We got,
that's the line.
And that's why people laughed, because they thought, ha, he's a funny dude for that.
All right, Juan. Michael Cohen, let's go back to the top. Anything you'd like to say about the former president's lawyer talking to ABC?
Well, I think one thing is clear. It's not, as the president wants to pose it, he said, me versus Cohen, and who are you going to believe, because Cohen has been proven to be a liar and he's going to jail. You've also got the National Enquirer head now saying the same thing. You have the Wall Street Journal saying, in fact, Trump was in the room for many of these discussions. And so it becomes like a, the weight of evidence is all on the side of Michael Cohen. And in response to what Greg just said, oh my gosh, you think about Flynn. He lied to the chief of staff. He lied to the vice president. He lied to the press repeatedly. This is all before the FBI gets involved. He was lying about his contacts with the Russians.
That doesn't excuse
we don't know why he's doing it.
I mean, that's the whole reason that criminal cases are tossed out, because of the chain of evidence being slightly tarnished. We as a republic support procedure and process. And
sure, but there's no tarnish here. He, in fact, then lied to the FBI, and it's been pointed out he was head of the National Security Agency. He was the National Security Advisor. He was a 32-year veteran of our military. My argument would be he should be held to a higher standard.
Well, you know what he should have done? He should never allow FBI agents to ask you questions without a lawyer present. You know, I never like to toot my own horn and steal things and claim that they're mine. So this is what I'm going to do. Brooke Sigmon, who's a producer here, wrote a great piece for FoxNews.com. Never heard of Fox. Great, yeah. Great resource. Yeah. False statement charges abound in Mueller probe, in contrast to Hillary Clinton case. And it lays out, I think, five people in this Trump orbit have been charged with making false statements. Tons of people lied to the FBI in the Hillary case. One person said that lying his ASS off. Can you believe I almost
said that? Oh, I know.
And they were never prosecuted for making false statements. There just seems like there's a little bit of a double standard.
Right now I can hear Shep throwing something at the TV.
Well, there's a point to be made there, right? Because the Democrats hate Comey as well as the Republicans hate Comey, right? Like, but it's interesting for him to go to the 92nd Y, and they're like, oh, well, we can forgive him. I'm thinking if I'm in the audience of the 92nd Y, which for those of you at home, just so you know, on the Upper East Side of Manhattan, liberal audience, okay? So you're sitting there and you're thinking, they wanted Hillary Clinton to win. They can't believe that this happened. But they blamed Comey for that. But they'll go and they'll pay money to sit and buy his book and listen to his spiel, because they actually hate Trump worse than they hate Comey.
Can't we all just agree, Juan, that we both hate Comey and just get it through?
I don't think Comey's the topic here.
But it was the second topic.
But you want to talk about Comey, you want to talk about Clinton, you want to talk about people who testified in the case that's been long settled. So
I want to talk about whataboutism run wild.
Here's
what I've learned. Look, we know Cohen is a bad guy. He's as tainted as potato salad left out for a week. But every president almost seems to have some shady friends, and this is why I'm not running for president in 2020. I don't want to take any of my shady friends down, because the moment that I take over in, say, 2024, they're going to start looking at all of you.
You're so altruistic.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm looking ahead. I'm talking, but like, everybody gets examined. That's the way politics is, and this is what
I mean. Even Dana, who is as clean as the wind-driven snow, would get caught up in a special
case. Oh, you don't know the things she's done behind the scenes. I know where the bodies are buried.
That's why I never ran for office.
Yes. Oh, that's the reason.
Quick point. Can I just say one thing, and that would be, if you are watching this thing, about Michael Cohen, if he's already giving interviews to the media, like he did this morning, that probably means, and you can check me on this, Emily, that he doesn't have a lot more to say to either the special counsel or to the SDNY.
I agree, and I was actually going to say to you that maybe a PR standpoint would be a different piece of advice than as an attorney, but I have been to multiple sentencings, and I have never in my life seen a more dramatic or, frankly, pathetic kind of exposition of it, woe is me, and this is why I did it, and lamenting before the judge. I have never seen such a lack of personal responsibility.
I have, and a vertebrae.
Stephanopoulos and the judge, or just before the judge?
The judge, and then going into the ABC interview, which I would never have advised him to do that.
Something changed, Emily, which is I think that the president, according to Cohen, went after his family, said, hey, look at his wife, look at his father-in-law. Look at where the money is. And I think Cohen then was like, well, you know what? I was covering for your dirty deeds, but no more, buddy. And so I think he's punching back in Trumpian style.
All right, Emily, we got to go, but also.